here we are again to be able to spend a few moments through this medium of video online to engage in the Word of God together. As we do so, we are in Acts chapter 23, and we're going to look at verse 11. That's all we're going to look at today as we bring our week to a close and a crescendo, and we're ready for this weekend. That being in mind, I want to urge you today, the decisions you make today prepare you and ready you for what you will do, not only tomorrow, but as Sunday approaches, the Lord's Day, and we gather to worship. And so I hope and pray that you will be making decisions today, getting your heart and mind ready, that you will recognize the need, the necessity, the benefit and blessing it is to you and to others to be able to gather with God's people. So starting out here to begin today, just to remind you, we would love to have you join us as we worship our Savior Jesus Christ Sunday morning. We are open fully. We still offer online, but our service starts at 11 a.m. And so we would love to have you at Trinity Presbyterian Church. If you already have a church family, I am not in the business of wanting to, as sometimes it's been referred to, steal sheep. If you have a body of believers that you are committed to and part of, please pour yourself in for the sake of Jesus Christ, for the good of one another and the growth of yourself. Pour yourself into that community. And if it's less than you long for it to be, that doesn't mean cut and run. It means double down in praying and working to see the Holy Spirit work and move in such a way that that church grows and matures into what it ought to be according to God's word, as God designs us to be the body of Christ. Well, here we're going to turn our attention to the word of God in Acts 23, verse 11. But before we do so, would you bow your head and pray with me? Lord, how good and pleasant and joyful it is to be able to gather like this, and what a joy it is to have breath in our lungs, to have a heart that beats. God, to be able to seek you and serve you, to have by grace our hearts and minds open to know you and love you. Would you speak, Lord, to our lives, your word of truth and your word of comfort? We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, Acts chapter 23. Paul has been arrested sometime previous to this. And having been arrested because the Jews were revolting against him in Jerusalem, arrested by the Romans in Roman custody. But even so, Paul has been allowed to bear witness, to share his testimony, to tell of the goodness of God and the hope of the gospel in Jesus Christ. And this all, again, kind of came to a head here at the end of yesterday's lesson. The mob became so violent that the Roman soldiers were concerned that Paul would be ripped to pieces. So they get him, they bring him back into the barracks. In verse 11 now of chapter 23, "The following night the Lord stood by him and said, 'Take courage, for as you have testified to the facts about me in Jerusalem, so you must testify also in Rome.'" Paul has sought to be faithful to Jesus Christ, to follow the leading and the prompting of the Holy Spirit who indwells him. And as I've been trying to point out, Paul's tactics have not been purely nor solely worldly or driven to preserve himself, but he is longing to make Jesus known. And God, in a vision, comforts him and assures him, "You have been faithful in the calling that I have had upon your life, and yet that calling continues. As you have proclaimed faithfully here in Jerusalem, now I want you to be in Rome." And this is insightful for Paul. Paul has a sense of what the Lord's will is. Now, my question for you, and perhaps also for me, is do you have a sense of what the Lord's will for you is? You know, Jeremiah 29:11, a famous t-shirt verse or verse to put on a refrigerator. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and give you a hope." This promise means that God has a plan for all of, for the life of everyone that is his child, that was redeemed by faith, a plan and purpose. And rather than it being, I have my will and I want God to baptize that, I want God to bless my will, we are to surrender to God, seek and know His will, and then be willing to pursue His plans and purposes, even if they aren't what we would have dreamed for ourselves. I'm going to sit before you not as one who from a very early age wanted to be a pastor. I didn't. I started out wanting to be a weatherman and then a school teacher, and I was going to be an elementary school teacher, was in graduate school to be a school teacher, and the Lord's plan and purpose was made known to me that God was calling me to ministry. And again, and you know, to this day, I do it, and I do it faithfully, and I do it with all my heart and devotion, but it's not the plan that I would have worked for my life. And it might be, you know, I look and say, oh, well, oh, so things would be so much better, or this or that or whatever. We must resist the urge, because where God has us is where God wants us and where God will use us for God's glory. Where God has us is where God wants us and where God will use us all for God's glory. You and I are the clay. The Lord is the potter, and the God is the one that is directing and determining His plan and purpose for our life. And this doesn't make us inconsequential. It just means that we are not the center of everything. God is. And we live to please and serve and know God. And in these plans and purposes, God does not leave us in the lurch. God doesn't abandon us. God doesn't say, okay, get this job done, now figure it out on your own. God is not only the one who has the plan and makes known the plan, but God is with us executing, working out, carrying out the plan, the purpose. You know, Jesus said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. He tells His disciples that all authority in heaven and earth has been given to me, so therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey all that I have commanded, and lo, I am with you to the very end of the age, at the end of Matthew 28. So it's very helpful for us to seek the Lord and ask God to grant to us an understanding of the plan and purpose He has for our lives. He may not tell you, He may not reveal it, but to ask Him, to seek Him. And then in asking and seeking Him, to be willing in faith to walk in the plan and purpose that He has for your life. Well, that's what Paul did. And Paul is assured and comforted and strengthened and blessed and fruitful for the glory and honor and praise of God. Would you pray with me? Lord, thank you for this day, and I pray that you would grant to us insight and knowledge and a sense of your plan and purpose for our lives. May we embrace it, and may we trust you. May we surrender to you and love you and be willing to follow where you lead and guide, all for your glory and for your goodness are the joy and delight of our lives. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, Lord bless you. Have a great weekend, and I will see you in worship Sunday morning.